In the exit meetings, you had said that you had hoped that Dwight would give you early notification because it would be easier for you to make decisions around the draft. But it sounds like it's going to go into free agency and into July. Is it hard to prepare for that? You have to have plans and then backup plans. Does everything really hinge on his decision?
Well, he still could, decide in his own mind early. But we're anticipating that, July 1st will come and he'll experience being a free agent, which is really what he's earned. And, once again, he can't sign anything anyway until July 10th. So, that's how we're going into it.
But does his decision ultimately impact really every other choice? I mean, if you have an all-star center or you don't, that's going to...
Absolutely.
Did you clear this interview with the PR department?
Josh is fine to talk about.
I'm not sure how many years ago it was, 2004. We went through the same thing with Kobe Bryant. So, it's not a fun experience, and there's a lot of anticipation. But it's not unusual in this business. And we were on pins and needles, until I believe it was July 15th, which is when Kobe notified us. So we'll be on pins and needles until we get notified again.
Why would you be optimistic about this? It seems like, the comments we hear, it's almost like he wants to have somebody sweep him off his feet and go somewhere else.
I haven't heard that. So I'm optimistic because of our franchise, the resources that this franchise has, and the city that we live in. That's why I'm optimistic.
Can you compare him to anyone else? He's been put in a kind of an unfair position. I mean, because the fans, for some reason, maybe because of the team's success or that he hasn't committed. I mean, the fans haven't really given him the benefit of the doubt. I mean, can you compare his situation?
No, I think you're right. I think that's a big part of it. And maybe even a bigger part of it was, because of his anxiousness to play, he probably came back a lot quicker than he should have. I've said many times I didn't expect him to come back until January or February, and he was there the first day of training camp. So, and I'm talking about from major back surgery.
Okay, I'm moving.
So, maybe looking back on it, he should have taken another month or two, but, my guess is even if he took a week or two and Steve Nash would have got hurt like he did, he would have wanted to get back in and help the team anyway. So you really can't look back on it and change what took place, but I think that had a lot to do with it. When he got his legs and got healthy, I mean, it was really a better player in March, in February than Dwight Howard in the NBA.
Have you gotten clarity from Metta or his representative about whether he's going to opt in or not?
No. Opt out. I'm not sure if it's opt in.
Exercise player option or opt out.
Yeah.
Is it hard to get clarity from Metta in general?
Excuse me?
Is it hard to get clarity from Metta in general?
Yeah, it is. It's not hard to get comments, and it's not hard to talk to him because he's very endearing to be around and talk to. But a lot of times you walk away and you're not as clear-headed as you'd like to be.
I'm glad we're kind of on the same page here because we'll have a conversation with him and then I leave the conversation wondering what he just said to me. When you have a business discussion with him, do you sometimes leave that business decision and think to yourself?
Not really.
Okay.
So sometimes I wonder if he does it to you on purpose. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
When I talk business with him, he's pretty good.
Hey, with all the talks about, the Clips and Doc Rivers. Do you think about what it's like to potentially even have Doc, not only in the Western Conference, but in the same building as the Lakers?
Yeah, I really don't want to comment. The person you mentioned is the coach for another team right now. So I don't know what's going on. I read the papers and I hear the reports. So I really don't know what's going on, other than what I think might be going on. But we worry about ourselves, and twice a year, or four times a year, it depends, home games, away games, we worry about the Clippers.
Yo, this your boy Dwight Howard, a.k.a. Superman, and you're watching LakersNation.com, baby. Yeah!